Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU channel. I want to begin to state that this video is not intended for beginners. The content within is based on my personal experimenter's results, information gathered from the internet, and my own understanding. It is important to note that following the steps outlined in this video could potentially lead to data loss, and in the worst case scenario, your computer inoperable. Any actions taken are solely your responsibility, and I provide no guarantee of success. That being said, if you are someone with technical know-how and you are interested in upgrading your computer to a new level or assembling a new system for your daily tasks, along with installing Windows 11 or creating a system backup, this video can serve as a valuable resource. It can help you be well prepared for any potential issues that may arise, allowing you to build your own computer and take control of the process, and learn how to tweak Windows 11 a little to make it clean and run faster. Let's get started. The story begins for last year when my old computer faced a crash. This led me to decide to assemble a new computer, tailored to my specifications from a computer store. Primary tasks for which I use this computer including designing models using software like AutoCAD, Fusion 360, or Blender, creating videos for YouTube using Adobe Premiere Pro, Photoshop, Illustrator, and handling daily tasks through Microsoft Office applications like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. Additionally, I used it for activities such as gaming and watching movies. Considering my main requirements and budget, I opted for a cost-effective configuration detailed below. CPU, i7-12700. RAM, 2 16GB DDR4, 32,000MHz. Boot driver, 500GB NVMe SSD, newly purchased. Additional drivers, 500GB SSD, 1TB and 6TB HDD, previously owned. Motherboard, ASRock B660 Pro RS. Power supply, 850W. Graphic cards, NVIDIA RTX 2070 8GB, previously owned. Displays, keyboard and mouse are retained from my old setup. These configurations served me well until this year, when I realized that my system partition was running low on space due to the increasing use of AI motors and control net functions and other AI projects. To address this, I decided to upgrade my NVMe SSD from 500GB to 2000GB. Before proceeding with the upgrade, I strongly recommended completing the following steps. Number 1. Backup data. Safeguard your data by saving it to an external driver, cloud storage, or any other secure location. This prevents data loss in case of unexpected issue during the upgrade. Number 2. Retrieve activation key. If you haven't already linked your Microsoft account to your computer, find and save your Windows 10 or 11 activation key. This will ensure that you can reactivate Windows after the hardware change. Open the registry editor by typing Red Editor in the Windows search bar or pressing Win plus R and typing regedit. Locate backup product key default under the editor submenu. Copy and save this activation key, and it is essential for reactivation. Number 3. Download Windows 11 ISO. Download the Windows 11 ISO file directly from the Microsoft website. There are three options for downloading. A. Upgrade for Windows 10. Not recommended. B. Download using the media creation tool. Recommended. C. Download the ISO directly. Recommended. If we choose the second option, which involves downloading a small application called the media creation tool, follow the instruction to download the ISO file to your computer, avoiding selecting to USB option, as we were creating a bootable USB using a different method. The third option offers more choice for selection. You can pick various language and other preferences. I had previously downloaded it, So now it is displaying an expired link. Interestingly, after downloading using these two distinct methods, I noticed that Windows 11 came in different sizes. The American English version is 700 MB larger. This suggests that there are components in the American English version not present in other English versions. Really interesting. Moreover, I recently learned from a video that if you download the American English version but choose International English during installation, Windows 11 will exclude TikTok and other third-party elements. This ensures a cleaner and faster running Windows system. Number 4. Download Rufus and create a bootable USB with Windows 11. Rufus is an open-source software that facilitates the creation of bootable USB drives. To acquire Rufus, simply perform a Google search and locate the appropriate version for your computer. Following that, insert a USB memory stick, preferably a USB 3, into your computer. This is crucial for a quicker backup process. Additionally, ensure that your USB has a capability exceeding 8 GB. If your USB device doesn't appear in this list, ensure that it is detectable by your system and restart Rufus. Next, select the Windows ISO file and choose the image option. Be cautious not to select the Windows to go option, which creates a portable Windows environment with limited functionalities. For a full Windows 11 installation, choose the standard Windows install option. This partition scheme is typically GPT. You can modify the USB volume label if needed. Leave the other parameters at their default settings. Rufus will present you with various options. Select the ones that align with your preference. Even with USB 3, the backup process can take around 7 minutes to complete. Number 5. Download Windows PE and create a bootable Hirens WinPE USB. Windows PE. WinPE is a compact operating system designed for the installation, deployment, and repair of various Windows editions, including Windows desktop and server versions. Essentially, it functions as a miniature Windows environment equipped with an array of tools. While utilizing Microsoft Windows PE can be somewhat intricate. So, we will choose the widely favored replica that provides simple usage and enhanced functionality. To proceed, visit the Hirens homepage and download the WinPE ISO file. To ensure file integrity, check the hash value. Open the folder containing the WinPE ISO file, highlight the entire path, and type PowerShell, then hit Enter. This will transition you into PowerShell mode, akin to the CMD command line interface, but more powerful. Input cert util hyphen hashfield hyphen hashfile hbcdpe iso sha 256 to obtain the sh6 256 hash value, which will verify the file's authenticity. You can perform similar check for other hash values. Utilize the up and down keys to retrieve previously used commands. Using Rufus, proceed to create a bootable USB with a WinPE environment. The process is similar to that of creating a bootable Windows 11 ISO. Following the same steps, you should successfully complete the process without encountering any issues. By adhering to these steps, you will be equipped with two bootable USB sticks containing both the Windows 11 installation and the Hirens WinPE environment. This ensures that you have versatile tools at your disposal for various tasks, and it is essentially valuable when addressing potential system-related challenges or maintenance requirements. At this point, the software aspects have almost been finalized. Now, you have two options to consider. Option 1. Transfer your old system to the new NVMe SSD. My new NVMe 2TB disk has arrived, accompanied by an NVMe case that can transform the NVMe disk into a portable USB Type-C drive. The distinction between a regular USB stick and this device is evident. Insert both the WinPE USB and the NVMe USB into your computer and reboot the system. When the welcome screen emerges, press Delete or F2 key to access the BIOS control window. Note that the specific key may vary based on your motherboard and the BIOS system. You can verify the BIOS information within this window. Remember, altering BIOS settings can modify your computer's hardware configuration. Navigate to the boot menu to select the boot sequence, or alternatively use another method. When the welcome window is displayed, press F11 to directly access the boot selection menu. Choose the USB WinPE option, and the system will commence booting Windows PE. Within the Hirens PE system, you will discover a plethora of beneficial tools designed to assist you if your computer encounters issues. Navigate to Disk category to find several disk-related tools. I recommend using Aomei for backing up and restoring your system partition or file system. It functions much like the former Norton Ghost, allowing you to back up the entire system into a single file and restore it to a new hard disk without encountering any problems. After installing a new system and completing all applications installations, I strongly advise making up the entire system. This acts as a safeguard for your new Windows 11 setup. Proceed to the clone option, which facilitates copying the entire hard disk to another one. Select your system HDD as the source and the new NVMe as the target. Initiate the clone process and, once complete, shut down the computer. Open the desktop case. Remove the screws securing the old NVMe disk. Insert the new one and secure it in place. This process is straightforward. Close the case, reboot Windows, and if all goes well, your old system has now been successfully transferred to the new NVMe hard disk. Option 2. Install a brand new Windows 11. Alternatively, you can opt for a completely fresh installation of Windows 11. For added security, backup the entire system to your hard disk prior to the installation. Use WinPE. This is an uncomplicated process following the provided instruction in Aomei. Now insert the Windows 11 USB into your desktop USB 3 slot and reboot the computer. When the welcome screen appears, press F11 and select the USB drive. The system will directly lead you to the Windows 11 installation screen. Initiating the Windows 11 installation process. Regarding the Windows 11 installation, numerous tutorials are available on YouTube. You can follow the steps they recommended. Additionally, refer back to the aforementioned instructions how to install a clean version of Windows 11. When prompted to provide an activation key, you can initially attempt to proceed without one. After the installation is complete, connect to the internet. If everything is in order, you may not need to activate Windows manually. If required, provide an activation key you obtained earlier. I reiterate the importance of backing up the entire system after completing the initial clean installation. Here are some useful tools you may be interested. Number 1. ATTO Disk Benchmark. This tool provides insight into the actual read and write speed of your USB, HDD, SSD, and NVMe devices. Number 2. CPU-Z, a widely recognized free software that offers detailed information about your computer's hardware components. Number 3. Syncbench. This software conducts benchmark tests to evaluate your computer's hardware capability. Number 4. Aomei One Key Recovery. This feature has been utilized by renowned computer brands such as Lenovo, Dell, and HP. it essentially restored the system to its factory default settings. Well, we can achieve the same outcome by using the Aomei restore function via Hirens WinPE boot. Utilizing the one key recovery method eliminates the need for a USB memory stick. Also, this convenience comes at a cost of approximately $300. An interesting revelation is that the Chinese version of Aomei's main homepage, situated in Chengdu, China, provides the software completely free of charge. The software can be downloaded from there. If you are not fluent in Chinese, you can easily translate the web page into English using Microsoft Edge. After downloading the software, you can directly launch the application from the zip file. While the initial interface might still be in Chinese, you can follow my guidance and choose the default setting. This action will create two additional partitions in your system partition. One for installing the WinPE system, so we won't need WinPE for booting up, and another for system backup. Given that my new 2000GB NVMe drive has an ample space, this function is well suited for it. Follow the provided steps, and you will be on track. Now you can customize the configuration. Typically, the F11 key is used to access the BIOS, and we have the option using the A key to enter Aomei's one key recovery. However, F11 works equally well. You might find the default 3-second timeout a bit brief, in which case you can increase it to 5 seconds. Consequently, when you boot up your computer, pressing F11 will take you to the boot menu. Even if you don't have a USB or DVD installed, from there, you can select Aomei's one key recovery, effectively retrieving your computer to the backup configuration, much like brand computers such as Lenovo, HP, or Dell. Or even better, given the presence of pre-installed software like the Adobe Suite, AutoCAD, Fusion, and Stable Diffusion, it is an ideal starting point. I wish you the best of luck in its process. If you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.